Well, to our elected officials, our sponsors, award recipients, honorees, and all of our esteemed guests, good evening and welcome to our Mississippi Magazine's most influential African Americans in Mississippi Gala, where tonight we will honor 25 individuals who are blazing trails, impacting positive change, and making Mississippi a better place for all of us to live. Plus, we are honored to pay tribute to six living legends who have made significant contributions to this state and this country, helping to pave the way for those in our past, our present, and our future. I am Erin Pickens, and I am so honored to serve as your MC for this evening's program. Mr. Wesley Wells is the founder and editor-in-chief of Our Mississippi Magazine, which is Mississippi's only statewide multicultural magazine. He had a vision to recognize the efforts and contributions that African Americans are making to this state. That vision aligns with the purpose of his magazine, and it is the vision that is brought here tonight. Now, not too often can we get leaders from across the state under one roof in one room for such an intimate setting. So we hope that before you leave this evening, you too will be amazed at some of the dynamic people in our communities who have done and continue to do amazing things. This is an opportunity to not only acknowledge their work, but to also network, get to know these individuals, and find ways where you can collaborate. We're also delighted to host this event in the capital city at this beautiful facility in the heart of downtown Jackson. We're bringing life back to downtown Jackson. And to share in the sense of warm hospitality from the city with soul is Mr. Ricky Thigpen, who serves as the interim president and CEO of the Jackson Convention and Visitors Bureau, but we call it Visit Jackson, which some of you all are doing tonight. Now again, we are so thrilled to have you as our guests and supporters as we pay homage to those who are making a difference for families who live in our community and throughout the state. This is definitely a celebration. Please welcome Mr. Thigpen as he comes to the podium with the opening remarks.
Thank you, Erin. I am Ricky Thigpen, and on behalf of Mr. Jackson, I am honored to welcome each of you to this very special event, right here in Jackson, Mississippi's capital city. Unfortunately, our state continues to be included on the list naming us close to or at the bottom, but tonight, we collectively honor heroes and heroines that call Mississippi their home, and because of their contributions and legacies, they propel Mississippi to the very top. In fact, many of their actions have helped shape this nation, and because of them, the United States, Mississippi, and indeed Jackson is a better place. I want to again thank each of you for coming out tonight, and on behalf of Mr. Jackson and all of Jackson City, congratulations, and thank you for your servant leadership. Good evening.
Now, this program wouldn't be possible without the generous contributions of our sponsors. Our dinner sponsor got their start as a bakery in Lee County, Mississippi, nearly 115 years ago, and has grown to be one of the region's strongest financial institutions. Renaissance Bank truly believes that innovation is one of the key drivers to community development, and it strives to develop partnerships in every community that it serves. Here to receive the Dinner Sponsor Award is Ms. Tracy Moran Adams with Renaissance Bank.
Thank you so very much, Erin, and good evening, everyone. On behalf of Mitch Waycaster, President and CEO of Renaissance Bank, and our Executive Chairman, Robin McGraw, I am privileged to be here this evening and to accept this recognition. And thank you sincerely for your generosity in recognizing our company. As has been stated, for 114 years, Renaissance Bank has remained committed in supporting many social causes that advance community and economic development within our footprint of service. We pride ourselves in this commitment and remain very devout in this position. Thank you again to Mr. Wells and the entire Mississippi Honors Organization for saluting Renaissance Bank, and we're very pleased to serve as this evening's dinner sponsor. Thank you.
And we do appreciate you so much, Renaissance Bank. Another round of applause. Now coming to the stage is a beautiful young woman who is bringing positivity to the world and is an inspiration to all of us. She's at Ole Miss, an integrated marketing communications major, and she hails from Boonville, Mississippi. And most importantly, she is our 2018 Miss Mississippi. Please welcome to the stage, Ms. Asia.
Consider all the worlds thy hand has made. We see the stars and we hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings our soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art. God, we pause this evening to honor you. We honor you for being God and for giving us the opportunity to celebrate all that you've created and done. We thank you, Father, for these leaders. Because whenever dark times has arisen, you've anointed influential leaders to be lights into dark places. Your antidote for the disease of social ills have always been leaders. So God, we thank you for these leaders that we celebrate this evening. We thank you for their courage and for their dedication to be innovators and change agents in Mississippi. God, we ask that you continue to bless them in a way that only you can. Bless their feet that they walk worthy of the calling that you have called them. Bless their hands that they may be productive toward the vision you have for this world Bless their voices that they may speak the truth with boldness, but also bless their hearts that their words are saturated with the love of God. Bless their minds that they may reject frustration and experience the peace that only you can give. Bless their spirit that they may, against hope, sometimes believe in hope. Bless those that are around them here and in this room and those that are not, that they may be encouraged to keep supporting these leaders. But most of all, God, bless their perseverance and their ability to keep going and not get weary in well-doing, because you have declared that in due time they shall reap if they faint not. God, how great you are, and it is because of your greatness we celebrate you tonight. In your Son Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
And with that, dinner is served. Our program will continue in just a few minutes.
The Shakers of Mississippi is part of the top stood that this particular recognition couldn't happen without first acknowledging the trailblazers who have done so much for the state of Mississippi, because they're truly in a class of their own. The Legacy Awards recipients are history makers, living legends, monumental contributors to this society. These recipients and their accomplishments will be talked about for decades and generations to come. They are Judge Reuben Anderson, the Honorable Mr. Robert Clark, Attorney Constance Lauren Harvey, Mr. James Meredith, Congressman Minnie Thompson, and Mrs. Burley Evers Williams. Here to pay homage to our Legacy Award recipients is none other than Mad Drama, who will be introduced by founder and director, Dr. Mark Henderson.
Good evening, wonderful people. We are Mad Drama Performance Troupe. It's so good to be among friendly faces and all these wonderful people. And Mad Drama is spelled M-A-G-D-R-A-M-A. And that means making a difference doing respectable and meaningful art. And we are always pleased when we're called on to pay tribute to giants in our community. We are proud that we've been doing this for a long time. This year, Mad Drama is celebrating our 20th year in existence. Of course, the students don't stay in school for 20 years, but we're glad that every 4 years or so we have new people. So tonight we have a tribute to these wonderful people, and I'm excited about it, because what we do when we have these kind of performances, the students have to go and research and understand, not just get up and talk about somebody. You need to know who you're talking about. So this is our tribute to all of our honorees tonight, Mad Drama Performance Troupe.
But he represents all of us. After all, he was the first known black student on an all-white campus. From Memphis to Jackson, he walked alone without fear.
But was stopped in his tracks because a bullet did pierce the flesh of his skin. But his spirit was strong. Although he left for dead, he got up and moved on.
A leader of yesterday.
And surely for tomorrow.
The legacy of James Meredith is one we should all follow.
Can you imagine running down your driveway, seeing the one you love in the worst way, drenched in a red shirt that was once white? June 12, 1963, turned her imagination into a real.
Although she faced this tragedy, a senseless, hate-filled casualty, she teamed with queens and made hope reality.
You see, Martin had Coretta.
Right.
Malcolm had Betty.
Mm-hmm. All right.
And Major had Murray. And oh, was she ready to fight an all-white jury.
Two times.
Took 30 years, but don't question God's time.
A leader of yesterday.
And surely for tomorrow.
The legacy of Murley Evers is one we should all follow. First is the word most commonly used to describe this lady. The first African-American woman to earn a law degree from the University of Mississippi.
The first
African-American judge in a land where black seeds grow strange fruit.
the first to speak, and she does it with humility, hope, integrity, and hard truth. As she walked through the segregated halls of Ole Miss, she was determined. She was determined to climb and overcome the fence of injustice.
That's right.
A leader of yesterday.
And surely for tomorrow.
The legacy of Constance Slaughter Harvey is one we should all follow.
A history maker with the heart of a JSU Tiger. Yeah. Although,
someone who was able to see the future bright.
Yeah.
Not just for Jackson,
Ebenezer,
or any city, but striving and working hard for a better Mississippi.
Yeah, that's right.
You see, he created so many opportunities for African Americans to shadow.
Right.
And if you ask him why he did what he did, he'll quickly respond.
Uh-huh.
Not for the Republican,
no.
Not for the Democrat, or any party, but striving and working hard for a better Mississippi.
A leader of yesterday.
And surely for tomorrow.
The legacy of Robert Clark is one we should all follow.
A protector and provider for his country and people.
Yes.
Trailblazing to a day where we all may be equal.
Right.
An advocate for change, ready for whatever may come. But what would you expect from a Jackson State alum?
All right. Now, this is a man who spoke for the Gulf Coast after Katrina.
All right.
A man who worked for adequate funding for HBCUs in Mississippi. This is a man who made sure first responders had every resource needed.
Yes.
A man who has held in public office since the age of 19.
19?
That's right, 19.
A leader of yesterday.
And surely for tomorrow.
The legacy of Bennie G. Thompson is one we should all follow.
Through the harassment from colleagues and being pushed onto his knees.
One man he knew clearly, he was going to get that law.
And when he got that law, he went from municipal to county to circuit all the way to Supreme Court judge.
He integrated over 100 school systems in the state and committed more than $200,000 to his dear old college home.
Yes, he is black, just like you.
And made something out of nothing, so you can too.
A leader of yesterday.
And surely for tomorrow.
The legacy of Reuben Anderson is one we should all follow.
And tonight.
This night.
Is their night. Thank you, legacy,
for showing us
how to fly.
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 Fourth, we were running late because we were doing something for the Department of Urban Planning Then we performed for the Males Conference on campus, and we had to do this. And I want to say to them that I'm proud of them for being the students that they are. Yes. And they should not hold their heads down for anything. I want them to walk out of here feeling proud. Come back up, man, brother. Come back up. Come back up, man, brother. I want you to get to know this. Come back up. And let me just say a little bit, about these students. Jackson State, we love Jackson State. It supports us in what we do. With these students don't get scholarships. There's no budget for mad drama, but they do it out of love. And you'll see in their introductions that probably only one of them are either a speech or theater major. So these are people who are committed, and they do it. So I just want to have them introduce themselves.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Jaquan Walker. I am a senior psychology major from St. Louis, Missouri.
Good evening, everyone. I am Christiana Moore, a sophomore business management major, theater minor from Augusta, Georgia.
Good evening, everyone. I am Janae Matthews, a junior elementary education major from Columbus, Mississippi.
Good evening, everyone. I am Jeremiah White, a speech communications major with a minor in sociology, and I am from Chicago, Illinois.
Hello, everyone. I am Morgan Eccles, a graduating senior child psychology major from Senatobia, Mississippi.
Thank you, and we hope to see you November 29th and December 2nd. We're doing our Christmas musical, The Nativity. Come out and support us. 20 years in the work. Thank you, Floyd. That's all right.
Another huge round of applause. I've been here for 16 years, and so I've seen Mark Henderson work with so many different groups from Mad Drama. I tell you, each one of the groups are dynamic, and they are awesome. Mark, you're doing an awesome job. Congratulations again, Mad Drama. Y'all were awesome. Yeah. Now, several of our Legacy Award recipients were unable to be with us due to previously scheduled engagements. They are, after all, sought-after speakers and teachers. However, we are very blessed to have two of them with us tonight. First, show your congratulations to attorney Constance Slaughter Harvey. Ms. Harvey, please come forward to accept your Legacy Award medallion. Now, I can't do it as dynamically as Mad Drama did it, but part of her bio, the first African-American female graduate from the University of Mississippi School of Law. She's an attorney, elections expert, educator, renowned speaker, mentor, author, columnist, mother, grandmother, and motivator of young news anchors when they move to this state to keep doing what they do. She's motivated me several times, and we appreciate you so much. We are honored to present to you the Legacy Award Medallion from Our Mississippi Magazine, and the plaque that reads, Our Mississippi presents this Legacy Award to Constance Laura Harvey in tribute to the significant contributions you have made to the state of Mississippi. October 25th, 2018, blazing trails, impacting positive change, making Mississippi a better place for all. Ms. Constance Laura Harvey. Do you have any remarks for us, ma'am? I know you're not going to shy away from the microphone.
Thank you so very much. I am indeed honored to have been selected to be honored tonight. And I am pretty much at a loss for words. Those of you who know me find that music. The greatest honor is to be recognized by your peers. And secondly, to be recognized by young people. I am particularly moved the young people would be here tonight and afford us an opportunity to continue to provide them strong shoulders upon which to stand, especially at times like this. And my prayer is that our young people won't have to endure what we endured in order to survive. And my prayer tonight is that there will be a place for hope for our children. And it's very serious. These are trying times. And if we can grab the hand of a young person and give them hope, in spite of the negatives coming from leadership, then the sacrifices that we made won't be in vain. I'm honored to be recognized with two men who mean so very much to me and my family. Robert Clark was my idol, my mentor. I've always looked up to him. I met him when he was a referee. He and my father were referees together. He was the smartest of all the referees because we had to give them tests. He was smart then. He's smart now. And I just feel so proud to be recognized with him. And then with James Meredith, who made it possible for me to go to the University of Mississippi School of Law. I think of his courage. I didn't have the same courage, and I was not as brave as he was, probably meaner than he was, but not as brave. And when I was told that these two men would be recognized tonight, I was overwhelmed. And Benny and Ruben are along the same age that I am, but then Merle Evers is one remarkable woman to constantly come back and try to hold the man who killed her husband, the father of her children, the man who motivated me. I see Carolyn Amoson here. He motivated us while we were too little. And to have him snatched away, and to have her turn around and continue his struggle and continue his work makes my heart happy. So Wesley, thank you so very much for honoring me, the individuals who are my idols and who are my mentors. And thank you all for coming.
Congratulations again, Constance Laura Harvey. Our next recipient is the Honorable Mr. Robert Clark. The first African American elected to the Mississippi State Legislature since Reconstruction, a true statesman, having the longest continuous service in the House and a Mississippi State building named after him. We are honored to present to you the Legacy Award Medallion from Our Mississippi Magazine.
House of Representatives,
I had to be elected as an independent during those times. But my motto was working, struggling, and pulling together for a better Mississippi. And I can remember during my first tenure, many of the other African-American officials that were elected, many of them didn't have any records or anything. They couldn't start. And I had to get a Bell Grant, and Tougaloo College, of course, housed me. I could not have gotten it at my alma mater, Jackson State, because it was a government university. And that, and we had to work to get those individuals, Justice Court Judge, papers, and everything that they needed. Now, I have retired from the legislature, but I have not retired from service. And what I am doing now is working with the elected officials throughout Mississippi to make Mississippi better and stronger. Several years ago, I saw a national report, and Mississippi was rated of all of the states in the United States at the bottom. And I know Mississippi, and I love Mississippi. And I know Mississippi is better than that rating. And I'm working with the elected officials throughout Mississippi for us to have a better and stronger Mississippi to represent who we really are. Thank you.
Congratulations again, Mr. Clark. Next, our recipient, hailing from the big city of Bolton to becoming the congressman from Mississippi's 2nd Congressional District, his life of service is impeccable. He has advocated for resources and reforms that benefit the entire state, and he stands firm in his fight to improve the quality of life of all Mississippians. Is there anyone here to accept the award tonight for the Honorable Vinnie G. Thompson? Well, let's give him a big round of applause. Next, a freedom fighter and warrior who has overcome institutions and systems that try to not only keep him out, but force his death. His perseverance and determination led him to lead the walk against fear, which inspired blacks across the state and this nation to register to vote. He is still organizing communities and teaching about citizen rights. Here to accept the Our Mississippi Magazine Legacy Award Medallion on behalf of Mr. James Meredith is Mr. Michael Harris, who serves as the program manager for Mr. Meredith's Institute for Citizenship Awareness and Responsible Engagement. Husband, Mississippi martyr Medgar Evers, and a desire to continue his legacy, she has created her own path dedicated to a life of service. Her commitment to education, civil rights, justice, and tireless efforts to help the underserved has been unyielding. Here to accept the Legacy Award Medallion for Our Mississippi Magazine on behalf of Mrs. Merle Evers Williams is her daughter, Rena Evers Everett.
Good evening.
This is a really impressive evening. But what I see is impressive people. And I'm bringing regards from my mother, who's in California, and regrets that she cannot be here with you this evening. And she sends her love out to each and every one of you. But to the legacy honorees, she gives a special hug and love because they've all been in the trenches together. To the 25 influential honorees, she says, keep the torches going. We have to keep not just the legacy of what we've been through, but we have to go ahead and, as Constance Slaughter Harvey said, take our youth, educate our youth, and take each other's hands and make sure we walk down this path together. There's some words, not long, that she asked me to say. So give me just a brief moment. She said to all of the honorees, a quote from my father, it's not just about me, it's not just about you, but it is about each and every one of us who live in the state and who embrace this country, the United States of America. Because regardless of race, creed, or color, we are all Americans. And she said to me, and I think she was quoted with this, we in America are still suffering. And we see this on the news 24/7. The same ills that were fought for over 60 years ago remain. But if Mississippi can rise to the occasion, then the rest of the country should be able to do the same. She says, thank you very much to Wesley Wells for this honor of our Mississippi and honoring the ones that are leading our state, but our country, to a better place for humanity. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And our last, but certainly not least, Legacy Award recipient is Judge Reuben Anderson, the first African-American Supreme Court Justice in the state of Mississippi and the current chairman of the Mississippi Civil Rights Museum. Please turn to the screen for Judge Anderson's acceptance.
Opportunity to thank the other honorees for all that they've done for me personally and for the state of Mississippi. I'd like to start out by saying how much I appreciate James Meredith, the most courageous and fearless man that I've ever known. I went to Ole Miss in 1965, 2 years after he did, and I have a tiny sense of what he went through. And I want to thank James for all the suffering that he's gone through. I'd like to likewise thank Merle Evans for all that she's done for Mississippi. And she too has been a Mississippian who has suffered immensely. Not only was her husband murdered, but she went through two mistrials in the trial of Beckwith. And in one of those mistrials, Governor Barnett came over and embraced Beckwith while she was on the stand testifying. That was the greatest injustice ever to happen in Mississippi. But in fact, he was convicted some 30 years later. And I'd like to thank Merle for all the work that she's done on the Civil Rights Museum, but for her, this Civil Rights Museum would not have been a success. And it is a success since we've had over a quarter of a million attendees so far. I'd like to thank and congratulate Representative Robert Clark. Robert Clark and I started out together in 1967. That was the year he was elected, and that was the year I began work with the NAACP Legal Defense Fund. And we represented Robert, Marilyn Wright, and I did when they tried to block him from taking his seat. He went from being one of the most hated members of the legislature to one of the most loved and respected. And he's done that great work over a long period of time. I'd like to likewise thank Congressman Thompson, an alderman, a mayor, a supervisor, a congressman, and a man who spent his whole lifetime working to make Mississippi a better place. Thank you so much, Mr. Congressman. And Constance Slaughter Harvey, whose family I've known for generations. Connie is originally from Forest, Mississippi. Her daddy was a great educator in Mississippi. He was the president of the Mississippi Teachers Association back in the 60s when we represented him. Connie has spent her whole career giving to Mississippi, most of it as a civil rights lawyer, integrating the schools, the state of Mississippi, and protecting voting rights. Thank you so much, Connie, for all that you've done. And thank you for recognizing me.
And congratulations to all of our Legacy Award recipients. Give them another huge round of applause. Now we've come to the presentation of our Mississippi Magazine's Top 25 African Americans in Mississippi. These individuals were first nominated by their peers this summer, then selected by an independent committee of nine in the areas of business, education, health, servant leadership to include government, military and civic service, entrepreneurs, and religious and spiritual professions. The top 25 are making great contributions to the growth and development of the state on a daily basis, and our Mississippi Magazine wanted to recognize their efforts. They're still paving the way through positive impact. To help me with the presentation is none other than Miss Mississippi Asia Branch. And the award reads, "Our Mississippi congratulates this recipient on being selected as one of Mississippi's most influential African Americans," and it has today's date. Those who are being recognized, please come to the board you see right here to my right to receive your award.
First up, it's Mr. Ronnie Agnew. Ronnie Agnew joined Mississippi Public Broadcasting in August 2011 as the agency's executive director after a career in the newspaper industry spanning nearly three decades. Before joining MPB, Agnew served as executive editor of the Clarion Ledger, the state's largest newspaper. Ronnie has been elected to leadership positions on several national public broadcasting boards, serving as chairman of America's public television stations and as former chairman of the National Educational Telecommunications Association. He is also a board member of the Organization of State Broadcasting Executives and the Associated Press Media Editors. He served as an adjunct communications professor at Belhaven University in Jackson. He is advisory board chairman for the journalism program at Jackson State University and is on the journalism advisory boards for the University of Southern Mississippi and the School of Journalism at Ole Miss. Ronnie holds bachelor degrees in radio, TV, and English from the University of Mississippi. He is married to Melody Billups Agnew and has three children. Mr. Ronnie Agnew. Next, Mr. Stan Allen. Stan Allen's voice has been the hallmark of his radio and TV career for more than 45 years. He became the first African American in history to sing in the University of Mississippi singing group called The Group, where he attended school. Those performances led him to becoming the on-air radio announcer at WCPC in Houston, Mississippi. He also worked for WLOV-TV Fox 27 as community talk show host of West Point of View for 12 years. Allen is an 8-time radio announcer of the year. He served active duty in Operation Desert Storm in Germany while working Armed Forces Radio during his tenure. Allen is currently the program director for Mississippi Radio Group in Tupelo, Mississippi, as well as afternoon drive host. He is a member of Masonic Lodge 494 in Tupelo and Phi Beta Sigma fraternity. Stan is blessed to be married 36 years to his beautiful wife, Sandra, and they have 4 children. Mr. Stan Allen.
Our next honoree is Patricia Bennett. Patricia Bennett is the Dean of Mississippi College School of Law. A Forest native and an MC Law graduate, she has dedicated her career to the law and legal profession. Before joining the MC Law faculty in 1989, Bennett worked as an assistant U.S. attorney in the U.S. Department of Justice. Her government service also includes stints as an assistant DA for Hinds County and Yazoo County, and as a special assistant attorney general with the Mississippi Attorney General's Office. For 8 years, Bennett served as a JAG officer in the U.S. Army, in Army Reserve, and the Mississippi National Guard. Her numerous professional affiliations include being elected a fellow of the American Bar Association Foundation. She's also a member of the Magnolia Bar Association and the Mississippi Women Lawyers Bar Association. She was named the Distinguished Professor of the Year in 2014, the university's highest teaching award. Dean Bennett was elected in January 2017 to serve as president of the Mississippi Bar. She and her husband Claude are Clinton residents and worship at Morningstar Baptist Church in Jackson. Dean Patricia Bennett. Our next honoree, Percy Bland. He is the 33rd mayor of Meridian, Mississippi, now serving his second term. Prior to his public service as mayor, he owned and operated a successful State Farm insurance company. The Percy Bland Insurance Company is noted in the top 3% of all State Farm agencies in North America. He received his BS in chemistry from Xavier University and earned his master's degree in public health from the University of Southern Mississippi. Bland was tapped to serve as one of the first professors in the Healthcare Administration Department at Mississippi State University's Meridian campus. He co-chaired the $19.5 million school bond issue for the Meridian Public School District and played a lead role in dropout prevention programs and has mentored countless young men and women in the Meridian District. He established his own summer basketball camp with more than 110 children in attendance annually and also helped to establish the first tee golf program in Meridian. He's married to Deidre, and they have 2 children. Mayor Percy Bland. Our next honoree, Dr. Sheila Bolden, MD. Dr. Sheila Bolden was born and raised in Jackson, Mississippi. She received her undergraduate degree in pharmacy from Xavier University of Louisiana. After establishing her career as a registered pharmacist and consultant pharmacist in the states of Tennessee and Florida, she decided to pursue a career in medicine. She attended the University of Southern Florida College of Medicine in Tampa and received her Doctor of Medicine degree before completing her residency training of obstetrics and gynecology at Arnold Palmer Hospital for Women and Children in Orlando in 1999. Following her residency, she returned to Mississippi and entered private practice at the Biloxi OBGYN Clinic. Although she thoroughly enjoyed the gratifying work as an OBGYN in private practice, her calling was to teach medical students and train future women health specialists. So she joined the obstetrics and gynecology facility at the University of Mississippi Medical Center in 2002 as an assistant professor. She progressed to that academic rank and tenured to later become the first African-American professor in the Department of OBGYN at UMMC in 2014. Currently, she is a second-year doctoral student in UMC's Doctor of Health Administration program. Dr. Bolden credits her faith in God, her supportive family, her hard work and perseverance, and her sense of community for her personal and professional accomplishments. Dr. Sheila Bolden.
Our next recipient is Ms. Carol Berger. Carol Johnson Berger served as the president and CEO of United Way of the Capital Area for 23 years. She continues as a consultant to the new president CEO until the end of this year. Prior to joining United Way, Carol was a teacher, human service administrator, and a business owner. Carol presently serves on the following local boards: Mission Mississippi, Greater Jackson Arts Council, St. Dominic Health Services Advisory Board, the Skills Foundation, and Springboard to Opportunities. Carol co-chaired with former Governor William Winter a strategic plan for the city of Jackson under the Mayor Harvey Johnson administration, and served as vice chair of the Secretary of State's Nonprofit and Charities Laws Study Group. Carol is a founding member and past president of the Mississippi Chapter of the International Women's Forum and Mississippi Chapter of the National Coalition of Black Women. If asked what she is passionate about, her response would be creating an educational environment where every child can be successful. Carol has one son, Marcus, and two grandchildren, Nicholas and Logan. She is a Tougaloo College graduate and a member of Anderson United Methodist Church. Ms. Carol Berger. Next is Alvino Castilla. Mr. Alvino is a native of Madison County, Mississippi, a partner in Butler Snow LLP at the Richland office. He is a graduate of Millsaps College, where he earned his BA and MBA degrees, and the University of Virginia School of Law, where he served as editor-in-chief of the Virginia Tax Review. He is also a certified public accountant. Mr. Castilla's law practice concentrates primarily on federal, state, and local taxation matters, including contested matters with the IRS and the Mississippi Department of Revenue. He also handles a variety of corporate, transactional, and financing matters. He is a member of the Mississippi and District of Columbia Bars, and he has also been inducted as a fellow of the Mississippi Bar Foundation. He frequently writes and lectures on federal and Mississippi tax law matters, and has been listed in Best Lawyers in America and Super Lawyers for many years. Mr. Castilla is an active member and a member of the trustee board at New Lake Church in Jackson, Mississippi, and enjoys fishing and playing golf as often as possible. He has two adult children, Mr. Alvino Castilla.
Next, Pam Chapman. Pam is the national and global television owner of the P. Chapman Network. She's the CEO and founder of P. Chapman Mentoring, Consulting, and Training Organization and Boss Lady P. Chat Business Coaching Outreach, which fosters teaching to women and young girls to love themselves first. Through her powerful and strong voice, she's traveled all over the South speaking and encouraging women to never give up on their dreams. This Rust College graduate is the first Black female news director in Mississippi. In 2016, she received the Mississippi Civil and Human Rights Award as a glass ceiling breaker, which was the first civil rights award held in Mississippi of that kind in honor of Fannie Lou Hamer. In October 2016, the U.S. Congress placed her in the congressional record for her career and community contributions. The following month, President Barack Obama honored her with the Leadership Achievement Award. The state of Mississippi also named the stretch of Highway 61 in her hometown of Shaw, Mississippi, in her honor. Ladies and gentlemen, Pam Chapman. Next, General Augustus L. Collins. He is the Chief Executive Officer of MINAC Incorporated, a major workforce development, training, and management corporation located right here in Jackson, Mississippi. Prior to accepting that position, Collins was the Adjutant General of Mississippi and served as the Commanding General of both the Mississippi Army and Air National Guard.
He served for more than 35 years in the United States Army and the Army National Guard, rising to the rank of Major General. From 2004 to 2006, he commanded the 155th Armored Brigade Combat Team during combat operations in Operation Iraqi Freedom. While deployed, he was promoted to Brigadier General, making him the first African-American to attain the rank of General Officer in the history of the Mississippi National Guard. General Collins currently serves on the Board of Directors of Huntington Ingalls Industries, Friends of Mississippi Veterans, and Minec Incorporated. He also serves as the President of the University of Mississippi Alumni Association. Collins received an Associate of Arts degree from Northwest Mississippi Junior College, a Bachelor of Business Administration degree from the University of Mississippi, a Master of Business Administration degree from Jackson State University, a Master of Strategic Studies degree from the United States Army War College, and has completed studies at Harvard University's John F. Kennedy School of Government, as well as Harvard Business School. That is General Augustus.
Dr. Beverly Wade Hogan is the 13th president of Tougaloo College and the first woman to lead the historic institution. She has a long and distinguished career as a public administrator, educator, community leader, and humanitarian. Her work as a mental health professional, government official, adjunct instructor in administrative law, leadership in public policy, and college administrator spanning more than 25 years, as well as her public speeches, public works, and community service address issues of education, health and human services, economic and social justice, civil democracy, and racial and gender equality. She is a national voice for higher education, currently serving on the United Negro College Fund. President Obama appointed her to the Board of Advisors for HBCUs, where she now serves as the advisory board chair for the HBCU Capital Financing Program. She has written and published several professional articles and is a contributing author for a textbook entitled Race and Gender, Leadership and Public Service. She earned a BA in psychology from Tougaloo College, a master's in public policy and administration from Jackson State University, and doctoral study at Fielding Graduate University in human and organization development. She and husband Marvin have two sons, two daughters-in-law, and seven grandchildren. Dr. Beverly Wade Hogan. Next is Mr. Shane Hooper. Shane Hooper was appointed as a board trustee for the Mississippi Institutes of Higher Learning to represent the 3rd Supreme Court District. He currently serves as president. Shane is a graduate of David Lipscomb University in Nashville, Tennessee. After graduation, he served his country as an officer in the United States Marine Corps. Shane also serves as the Director of Development Services for the City of Tupelo and is the president of Professional Training Consultants, a training provider for the insurance and financial services industry. Active in the community, Mr. Hooper is past president of the Tupelo Rotary Club, past president of Gardner Simmons Home for Girls, and past president of United Way of Northeast Mississippi. He currently serves on many boards. He and his wife, Sarah, have two sons and one daughter, Mr. Shane Hooper.
Edmund E. Hughes, Jr. He is the Vice President of Human Resources and Administration for Ingalls Shipbuilding. A native of Jackson, Mississippi, Hughes holds a bachelor's degree in chemistry from Tougaloo College and an MBA from Indiana University. He was recognized by the Sun-Herald as one of South Mississippi's outstanding community leaders. Last year, Coast Young Professionals recognized him with the Forever Young Award for giving back through mentoring. He serves on the Board of Directors of Alabama Mississippi Chapter of the National Multiple Sclerosis Society and the Gulf Coast YMCA. He's the Vice Chairman of the Board of Trustees for Tougaloo College and is a 2012 graduate of Leadership Mississippi. Mr. Edmund Hughes, Jr.
Next, Derek Johnson. On October 21st, 2017, the Executive Committee of the NAACP National Board of Directors elected Derek Johnson President and CEO. He formerly served as the Vice Chairman of the NAACP National Board of Directors, as well as State President for the Mississippi State Conference of the NAACP. Born in Detroit, Derek attended Tougaloo College and continued on to Houston, Texas to receive his Juris Doctorate from South Texas College of Law. He furthered his training through fellowships with the Congressional Black Caucus Foundation, the George Washington University School of Political Management, and the Massachusetts Institute of Technology. Johnson is a veteran activist who has dedicated his career to defending the rights and improving the lives of Mississippians. In recognition of his service to the state of Mississippi, the Chief Justice of the Mississippi Supreme Court appointed him to the Mississippi Access to Justice Commission, and the Governor of Mississippi appointed him Chair of the Governor's Commission on Recovery, Rebuilding, and Renewal after the devastation from Hurricane Katrina. In the wake of Katrina, Mr. Johnson founded One Voice Incorporated to improve the quality of life for African Americans through civic engagement training and initiatives. Here to accept the award on his behalf is Mississippi NAACP Executive Director, Corey Wiggins. Next, David Marion, PhD. Dr. David Marion is owner of Marion Consulting Services, PLLC, a mental health clinic that specializes in providing individual, group, marital, or couple or family consulting, psychological evaluations, psychiatric evaluations, and employee assistance programs to organizations throughout the state of Mississippi. He's been in the counseling field since 1992 and in private practice since 1998. He holds a PhD in counselor education with a minor in public administration and public policy from Mississippi State University, a master's degree in rehabilitation counseling from Mississippi State University, and a bachelor's degree in business administration from Jackson State University. Dr. Marion became a member of Omega Psi Phi Fraternity Incorporated in 1979 through the Eta Psi chapter in Starkville, Mississippi. This past July, Dr. Marion was elected Grand Hospitalist of Omega Psi Phi and is the first Mississippian to be elected as a national seat for the fraternity. Dr. Marion has been married to the lovely Dr. Joyce Cole Marion. She's a licensed clinical psychologist and co-owner of Marion Counseling Services. They've been married for more than 18 years. He has two children, Dr. Chelsea Marion, a physician in Atlanta, and little Chloe Marion, a 10-year-old, as they call the boss of many. Dr. David Marion.
Reverend Joe Willie May. Reverend Joe Willie May is the pastor of Anderson United Church in Jackson, with about 4,000 members. Since 1978, his ministry has included rural churches, small town churches, and city pastorates. A native of Waynesboro, Mississippi, he is a graduate of Rust College and Hamler School of Theology at Emory University in Atlanta, Georgia. Joe has given distinguished service to the church as pastor, administrator, teacher, and various committee and convention positions. For 8 years, he served on the general board of church and society, and presently serves on the Southeastern Jurisdictional Committee on the Episcopate and the general board of discipleship. In every ministry setting he enters, he creates an open, hospitable space in which others experience God's healing, presence, and know their own gifts to be affirmed. Joe is married to the former Suzette Donner of Dundee, Mississippi, and they are the proud parents of three lovely children. Reverend Joe Willie May. Next, Sharon McDougall. Sharon joined NASA in 1990, where she worked in the Space Shuttle Crew Escape Equipment Department as a CEE suit technician. She was responsible for processing the orange launch and entry suit assemblies worn by space shuttle astronauts, most notably Dr. Mae Jemison, for her historic mission aboard Space Shuttle Endeavour. McDougall was one of only two women technicians and the only African-American technician when she began her career. She was later promoted to the position of crew chief, making her the first woman and African-American CEE crew chief. She had the honor of being the first and only all-woman CEE crew. A decade later, she became the manager of that department, adding crew recovery upon landing to her duties. She held that position until the space shuttle program ended in 2011. She continued working until 2012 to help close out the program, ending an illustrious 22-year career. An Air Force veteran, she was an aerospace physiology specialist, responsible for training and suiting up pilots for high-altitude operations. Sharon has been happily married to her husband, Marinol, for 26 years, and they have two children, Miss Sharon McDougall.
Sharon McDougall is from Mrs. Mississippi. Next, we have Kathy Northington. Kathy serves as Chief Operating Officer for the Mississippi Economic Council, the State Chamber of Commerce. Northington began a decade ago as part-time and entry-level employee and worked her way up from the ground floor. In her current role, she facilitates Leadership Mississippi, the nation's second oldest leadership program, and oversees the production of MEC's three major meetings, with each having more than 1,500 business and community leaders and elected officials attending. Kathy hopes through programs like Leadership Mississippi and the great MEC events that they can help build a sense of statewide business community. The Jackson native studied marketing at Mississippi College and enjoys giving back to the community through her volunteer work as a member of Junior League of Jackson with Special Olympics and American Cancer Society. A mother of three, Kathy is also a member of the Madison Ridgeland Rotary Club and a board member of Goodwill Industries of Mississippi. It's Kathy Northington. Next, Dr. Alfred Rankins Jr. He was appointed to serve as Commissioner of Higher Education by the Board of Trustees of the State Institutions of Higher Learning this year. Dr. Rankins provides leadership to the university system, including all 8 public universities in Mississippi. Prior to being named Commissioner of Higher Education, Dr. Rankins served as the 19th president of Alcorn State University, the nation's oldest public land-grant HBCU. Under his leadership, the university excelled in academics and athletics and was noted nationally for its commitment to student experience. Prior to his appointment at IHL, Dr. Rankins served on the faculty of Mississippi State University, where he was a tenured associate professor in the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences and extension specialist with the MSU Extension Service. Currently, Dr. Rankins serves on the State Workforce Investment Board and Energy Mississippi Advisory. A native of Greenville, Mississippi, Dr. Rankins received a Bachelor of Science degree from Alcorn State University and both Master of Science and Doctor of Physiology degrees from Mississippi State University. Dr. Alfred Rankins Jr. Next, DeKeither Stamps. Councilman DeKeither Stamps is an Iraqi war veteran, entrepreneur, farmer, father, and leader of Ward 4 in the city of Jackson. After graduating high school, he joined the U.S. Marine Corps. During the next 3 years, Stamps traveled around the world as a presidential security guard to almost every state in the Union and 18 countries overseas. He did that with former President of the United States, Bill Clinton. In 2005, he re-enlisted to join the Army and requested to be sent to Iraq. He credits his experience as a patrol leader for a 17-man unit and a 4-vehicle ground patrol in Iraq as the catalyst which strengthened his role as a leader. Under Councilman Stamps' leadership as council president, the council has passed several ordinances which are designed to bring a better quality of life to citizens of Jackson. His passion for education, economic development, and community revitalization continues to form the foundation of his work in the city of Jackson and beyond. In 2015, he was elected second vice president of the National Black Caucus of Local Elected Officials. A year later, first vice president, helping to lead the presidential transition through an appointment by President Obama. And last year, he became president-elect of this group. In this role, he has successfully raised money for the organization, and he will be installed in November, that's next month, as president of the National Black Caucus. He is a proud husband and father of 3 daughters. This is Councilman DeKeither Stamps.
Thank you. Sean Sucks. Sean is the president at Toyota, Mississippi. Prior to his promotion to president, Sean served as vice president of manufacturing and vice president of administration. Before joining Toyota, Sean served as director of strategy and administration and human resources from Nissan's North American headquarters in Franklin, Tennessee. He also directed production quality at the company's manufacturing and assembly plant in Canton, Mississippi. Additionally, Sean is a military veteran, having served in the United States Army for 8 years. Sucks was appointed to the State Board of Education, a 9-member board responsible for setting state education policies and standards in 2017. He also serves on the Mississippi Economic Council's Executive Committee and serves as a board member for the Mississippi Manufacturers Association. Sean earned a Bachelor of Science degree from Oakland City College in Oakland City, Indiana, and his Master's of Business Administration degree from Auburn University. Sean and his wife, Janet, reside in Saltillo, Mississippi, which places him close to his 6 children and their families. Mr. Sean Sucks. Next is Ms. Tammy Tubbs. Tammy Tubbs is truly an overcomer and an inspiration to many. She is the mother of Trinity and the late Terrence and Tyler Tubbs. She serves as an ordained minister of Peters Rock Temple Church of God in Christ in Starkville, Mississippi. A television host, life coach, motivational speaker, published author, and certified teacher, Tammy serves as the executive producer and host of her own television show, The Tammy Tubbs Show, which airs on Christian Television Network. Tammy was instrumental in launching the first parent cafe model through the Starkville Otakabea School District, marking Mississippi as the 13th state in the nation to use the model to assist families with developing and improving parental skills. Tammy recently published her third book entitled, I Survived Death, Depression, Divorce. Her first book, I Still Have Joy, is in memory of her sons who passed away from spinal muscular atrophy. I'm so sorry. The number one genetic killer for children under the age of 2. A 1998 graduate of the Mississippi University for Women, she is currently employed with Starkville Otakabea Consolidated School District as a family and consumer science teacher. Tammy is a member of Zeta Phi Beta Sorority, NAACP County Chapter, and parent advocate for families of spinal muscular atrophy, among others. Ms. Tammy Tubbs.
Next, Patricia Wise. Judge Pat Wise was elected in 1989 as a chancellor of the 5th Chancery Court District of Mississippi. She received her Juris Doctorate from the University of Mississippi. She was appointed by the State Supreme Court as a member of the Judicial Complaint Tribunal, which she formerly served as chair. Judge Wise was the first female president of the Magnolia Bar Association. She and her daughter, Attorney Crystal Wise Martin, are the first and only legacy presidents. Judge Wise is a recipient of the University of Mississippi Now Award, which is an award of distinction in recognition of outstanding leadership, and the first recipient of the Black Women's Political Action Forum Brown Hall Young Achievement Award, given in recognition of outstanding contributions to the legal profession. She is a life member of the NAACP and Zeta Phi Beta Sorority Incorporated, a former board member of the Metro Jackson Chamber of Commerce, and was selected to the Class of Leadership America, an organization comprised of 100 women leaders across the nation. She and her husband, Mark, have been married for 45 years, and they have 2 daughters and 6 grandchildren. Judge Patricia Wise. Next, Camille Scales Young. Camille Young brings more than 2 decades of background in the practice of state and federal government affairs to her role as principal and director at Cornerstone Government Affairs. In addition to her capital lobbying task on behalf of a diversified clientele, she also provides significant public affairs support to clients in areas of public relations and community relations.
Camille serves on the boards of Greater Jackson Chamber Partnership, Mississippi 4-H Foundation, and Bank First, and is a member of Mississippi Power Company, the Woodland Hines Educational Foundation, the William Winter Institute for Racial Reconciliation, and Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority. First time I've got to say that to Camille grew up in Shannon, Mississippi, and graduated with a BA and a master's from Mississippi State University. Camille and her wonderful husband, Keith, are the proud parents of three amazing children, and they enjoy living in rural Madison County. This is Camille Scales Young. Next, Dr. Jerry Young. In 2014, Dr. Jerry Young was elected as the 18th president of the National Baptist Convention USA Incorporated. Dr. Young has faithfully led the vibrant congregation of New Hope Baptist Church since 1980. To date, the ministry is comprised of more than 3,000 members and 44 ministries. He's the founder and headmaster of New Hope Christian Preschool and New Hope Christian Elementary School, together serving 300 plus students from infants to sixth grade. An avid scholar and lifelong learner, Pastor Young attained an Associate of Arts in Social Science from Cahoma Junior College in Clarksdale, and a Bachelor of Science in Sociology and Social Welfare from Rush College in Holly Springs, Mississippi, and that's where he met and married the love of his life, Ms. Helen Atkins Young. He went on to earn a Master of Divinity and a Doctor of Ministry from Reformed Theological Seminary in Jackson. Presently, Dr. Young serves on the Board of Trustees at Belhaven College, Belhaven University, in Jackson, Mississippi, as well as his alma mater, Russ College in Holly Springs. He is an immediate past president of the General Missionary Baptist State Convention of Mississippi and immediate past vice president at large of the National Baptist Convention USA. He and his wife, Helen, are the proud parents of two daughters, and they have three granddaughters and two grandsons. Dr. Jerry Young. And last but not least, Mike Espy. Mike Espy is the former Secretary of the United States Department of Agriculture and a former U.S. Representative from the 2nd District of Mississippi, who is now running to be the next U.S. Senator from Mississippi. He currently works as a private sector attorney, counselor, and agricultural advisor, having his own law and consulting firms. Prior to his appointment as USDA Secretary, Mike Espy served for 7 years as a member of Congress, becoming the first African-American of that body from the state of Mississippi since the Reconstruction era. Before his election to Congress in 1996, Espy worked as a trial lawyer and served as Assistant Attorney General and Director of Mississippi's Office of Consumer Protection. In 1980, he was appointed as an Assistant Secretary of State and served as Director of the Office of Public Lands. He received a BA degree from Howard University in Washington, D.C., and went on to receive his law degree from the University of Santa Clara. He is married to the former Portia Denise Fowler and is the father of three children. Attorney Mike Espy. And that is it for our top 25, and we want to give everyone a big round of applause. And we do want to ask for our top 25 who are still here at the end of our program together across the front, because we want to take a big group picture of everyone. Congratulations again. We'll continue blazing trails, impacting positive change, and making Mississippi a better place for all. I especially want to thank Miss Mississippi for helping me present these awards tonight. And I'd also like to thank Miss Black West Hines County, Kaylee Hargrove. And Miss Black Central Hines County, Brittany Morgan, for their presence and help. Now at this time, we also want to present our sponsor awards. As I call your agency, we ask that the representatives stand, and our Hines County Queens will bring you your plaque. First, our gold sponsor, Nissan.
Our silver sponsors. One is Bancorp Sound. And the other is Ingalls Shipbuilding. Our bronze sponsors this evening, Atmos Energy. Cornerstone Government Affairs. And Visit Jackson. And let's show our appreciation to our sponsors once again with another round of applause. Well, this has truly been a wonderful program and could not have happened without your support. We look forward to continuing the partnership for years to come. We'd also like to acknowledge Thomas Tiger Roots, the saxophonist for this evening, the Westin Hotel, Faye Foster Decor, and Lady Godiva Productions. Congratulations once again to all of our recipients and honorees. Also, thank you so much for allowing me to MC tonight. And a point of personal privilege. It is 8:45. I'm normally in the bed right now, so I need y'all all to wake up in the morning and watch 16 WABT News. The 16 WABT News is... That's what I'm talking about. Thank you very much. I'll be there right now. Next, with our closing remarks, is our Mississippi Magazine publisher, Mr. Wesley Wells.
Hello, everyone. Hello. I won't keep us much longer. I know it's been a long evening, but when I saw, a quick note, when I saw the order of the program and I saw I was on there last to come behind everyone, I told our event planner, I said, look, I am not going up there behind all these high achievers, so that's not going to be a good look for me. But anyway, I want to thank everyone for coming. I know the weather wasn't that great today, but as I look over the room and I see all of you in here, it just makes me so proud, really proud, that you will come out and support our award recipients. So let's give them all a hand. And one other thing, as we leave here tonight, I want everybody to be careful driving home and make note, we've got another event coming up next March, March the 23rd, our Mississippi Honors, where we do a very important thing. We honor Mississippi Corporation for their diversity practices. So we'd love to see you in Tupelo next spring. And on that note, we are done.